Traders, the end of the trading day for me today and the end of the trading week too. I'm going to finish in green, as you can see here. I'm up $7,600, a bit more open in AMD short, which is doing good too. And three winners, just one loser, solid day. And there's several things I would like to talk to you about. So let's take a quick look at some of the trades today, because I think there were some things that should be remembered. I start with AMD. That's a technical pattern that you need to remember. It's a very interesting technical pattern. Like, take a look at AMD, which started with a big gap down today. It was on my shortlist today. If you watched my shortlist today pre-market, you could have seen AMD there. So it was on my shortlist. However, it did not give me a chance to participate because it just started. First 1 minute candle, it spiked up and down and then immediately came down. It was extremely dangerous to trade. Of course, you take a look at something that looks like that. You saw you did not participate in a trade like this, but you can't trade it. It's too dangerous to trade. So AMD did move down. However, then a very big move up. Now, what about this big move up? I mean, something definitely going wrong, right? So why does AMD change its direction intraday? Is it because something intraday good happened to AMD? That's easy. You can look at online and find out. I don't need to look online. I just look at the volume and I can see that there's nothing special that happened intraday. It's just some averaging down losses. It's just some people who are bottom fishing and thinking they could make money. They actually did, because look at how AMD moved up from the lows. Just remember this pattern, because this pattern is a very shortable pattern. You just look for the point where the buyers, the one who averaged down their losses or whatever it was, for whatever reason, they're probably out, because you know it started with bad news today. That's why it gapped down. That's why it's more likely for it to gap and go. Does it always work? Do we have 100% success rate in this kind of trades? Absolutely not, but I promise you more than 60%. So look for a stock that started extremely weak, moved up, and you look at it and you're amazed. I mean, why? What happened there? At this point here, I was interested in shorting, and then it spiked over the highs. I'm still waiting. I'm waiting for a failure. Now, a failure after moving to a new high is even better. At that point right over here, we shorted it, 84.85. That's the point of no return. That's the point once it tried to move higher, that's the point where it's more likely to fail. Again, more likely to fail. Nobody promises a good trade, but as you can see here, it just moved more than the point, and it was a beautiful opportunity. Now, the same thing, although a little bit different, happened to GME today. Look at GME. Started with a gap down, trying to move higher, and then spiking over the highs, in fact, even closing the gap here. You know, there's two things here in GME. First, you should be surprised of this big upside move. You should be surprised, because it's not supposed to. It started with a big gap down. It's supposed to come down. Well, it did move up that much, but then you've got the same kind of reversal. But the GME trade is a little bit different, and we shorted this one too, and it worked out nice. The GME trade is a little bit different because you need to take a look at the daily. The daily is extremely dangerous because yesterday it had a huge upside day, as you can see, without a gap, almost without a gap. And then you expect some profit taking today. So we did use the profit taking. At that point, it was very red, so it worked out nicely. Now you can see that it is returning to the highs. You never know with a stock that is so strong, but you expect some profit taking after a big move. And especially with this pattern, when you can consider it, where it's very likely for it to come down. So these were two of my short trades. Another short trade I had was XLNX. And that was a totally different type of trade. I mean, the stock is up 13%. It started a bit higher than that. It started at 16% or so. When the stock is gapping up that much, it is usually under a pressure. The bigger the gap, the more pressure. You expect it to gap and go. Yes, sometimes, but when you see that it's getting to the lows and with such a nice technical formation, that's where we shorted it, then it looked really nice for a continuation, and it did work out nicely. I did mention with XLNX that it's going to be a scalp, meaning I do not expect it to continue much. That was a trade where I would be very happy to take my partial somewhere and just leave very small size, if at all. And I did move out when it started moving sideways. I don't trust it. It's a huge gap up, but under a lot of pressure. If the pressure comes in where you see the S&P trending lower, and yes, the S&P was trending lower. Let's take a look at the S&P. You see, there's some pressure coming from the market. So there's some backwind as the S&P is moving lower. I can say the same about the Nasdaq, but the Nasdaq is less important. So when you have the combination of a stock that looks like it's going to come down, technically speaking, a very big gap up, not a big gap up, a very big gap up, and a nice technical formation, of course, the market working your way, then you probably have a chance to short it, which could be interesting. And again, we took this trade. It worked out nicely. I did have one loser in Nvidia, which I was expecting to come down, and I'm looking for it to see whether I was just thrown out of it. I don't have it on my chart. Yes, well, it did come down after all, but it spiked up and took me out. Anyway, that's my only loser today. So I'm going to finish nicely in green today. It is a Friday. It's usually harder to make money on Fridays. And if you guys are on the green side today, then again, it's a bit harder to make money on Fridays. Just I wish you a great weekend. Just enjoy the rest of your weekend. And I'll see you all back here on Monday. So rest well. And let's meet next week again. If you guys are on YouTube and like to give us a thumb up, we will appreciate it very much. I think we earned it today. So thank you all. I'll see you all next week. Bye, traders.
Thank you for watching our video. Before you go, we invite you to take Trader's free welcome course. It was designed to teach you the basics of Wall Street trading. Click here to sign up for this no risk, no cost offer. If you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel where you can view many more stock trading videos. Questions or comments, please submit them below.